guys, what's up? Welcome back to another tutorial where I'll be showing you this dice. Really cool model. It's designed by Wayne Brown. This is actually not very good. The way I folded it, this is supposed to be the 4. By the way, the white parts are the dots. Okay, I folded this wrong. I mean, I folded it as the diagrams, but they were assuming that the white part was the part that's going to be, they're going to be the dots. But anyways, so as you can see, we have the 5, 1, 3, 2, this is supposed to be the 6, I know it. So 3 in this side, 3, but it doesn't have the divisions. I think it's because I folded it wrong, but I'll try to make it better in this one on this tutorial. And this is supposed to be the 4. This one I just had trouble with. This corner doesn't look good, but I guess it has 4 dots. But anyways, it's not so hard to do, and I'll try to do my best to teach you. So let's get started. You might want to use. Anyway, you need to use double colored paper, so okay, let me just okay, let's get started. So first off, you're going to oh, by the way, and this in this video I'll be showing you how to make the black part on this cube will be the white part. Okay, so the dots will be blue. Okay. So first off, we're going to make some break creases, and so you're going to fold the diagonals. Okay, now just fold in half, vertically and horizontally. Okay, now we are going to divide diagonally into 4 parts. So you just fold the 4 corners to the center point. Okay. Just do it with all 4 corners. By the way, this knife is the paper, it's not me. Okay. Now. So we're going to make some. We're going to deal with this square first. So you're going to fold this edge to the middle line. Now you don't need to fold all the way. You're going to fold all the left side like this and make a pinch. So here's the diagonal line, make a pinch about something like about here, okay? Okay, just like this. You can just fold all the way, it doesn't really matter, but then you're going to fold to that line, this edge to that crease you just did. Now you can fold all the way. Like this. Then, you're going to rotate the paper like this. And you're going to bring this edge to the middle line again. Don't fold all the way. So fold from the diagonal to the right, okay? Like this. Okay, now we have this little square here. You're going to bring this point here. Like this, repeat, bring this point to the crease you just did. And now you're going to make a line like this, okay, from this point. So just bring this point up, align it so it's in this point. Okay, and just fold this up, align it with the diagonal, just pinch on the point, don't fold all the way, just till here, okay, just like this. Okay, now you're going to rotate the paper and bring this edge to this line. The next line, okay, and you're going to fold to this crease here, okay? You have a line going like this, just fold to here, and also from on this side, just fold from this point, okay? Basically, just don't fold in here again. You can fold it if you want it. Like this. Now we're going to make some lines here, like these two. Okay, you can make these two lines, this one and this one. So just bring this edge to the crease you just did. This just fold this part, okay? Not all the way. This, and do the same thing with the other side. Just bring this edge to this line. And again, just fold this point, this part here, sorry. Okay. Now, you're going to make a line from this point to this point. So, rotate the paper like this. So, we started off like this, okay? Rotate this and bring this edge to this line, okay? I hope you can see it on white, like this, okay? Oh, sorry. And just fold here. Okay. Okay, now you're going to make another line from this point to here. Okay, this line. I will post. I'll have to figure out how I do it, but I'll post a picture on the video to see what creases I'm talking about. Okay. I mean, I will try to do it. I don't know if I can. Okay, but anyways, so just bring this point up, pinch on the point, and the line is align this to the diagonal. And pinch on these two points. Okay, like this, this line right here. And you're going to make an horizontal line from this, from the same point to here, okay? So just fold it like this, fold this up and fold this edge to this line, okay? Don't fold all the way, just fold this part here and the same part on the other side, okay? More or less. It's to this line, okay? Like this. Now unfold. Now we are going to make line from this point again horizontally, that to that point. So just rotate paper and just fold this edge to the middle line. This hold here and just crease it. And you're going to do another fold on this side, and it's so you have the diagonal line here, okay? This is the point. Fold it to the left, okay? Just a little bit, like this. Okay, fold. Now, we have this line here, right? You're going to make a... no, sorry, this is easy. So, you have this line, okay, not the one you just did, but the previous one, this one, you're going to bring this edge to that line, making a crease like this, don't fold all the way again, just about here, okay, and fold. Now you're going to do the same thing, but align this edge with this line. And you fold it until you reach the line you just did. So until here. Okay, like this. Now we're going to rotate 180 degrees and you're just going to bring this edge to this line, just like this. Make sure to align it, and you're going to fold from this point here up to this line, okay, up to this one. So just this part, like this. Now you're going to make from this point, you're going to make a line going up, okay? It should be, if you fold this edge to the middle and it should already be folded. I just forgot to fold this small part on the top like this. Okay, now you're going to bring this edge to the line you just did, like this. Don't fold all the way. Just until you reach this line here, okay? Like this. Okay, so now... okay, we still have one thing. You're going to bring this bottom edge to this line here, okay? Wait, let me do something first, sorry. You're going to bring the bottom edge to this line, okay? Like this. And now you can fold all the way. Okay, now you're going to bring this bottom edge up to this line, like this, and you're going to fold from the line you just did, so it should be an intersection right about here, and just fold from that point all the way to the left. Just like this. And now from that same point, right here, just fold it down. So bring this edge. Like this. Okay, you can just fold this edge to this line right here. Okay. Like this. And you can fold from that point, okay, all the way down, and you have another fold here on the top from this diagonal line here, like this, okay, from this point. Okay, we're almost done now. So from the fold you just did, this one, okay, you're going to bring this edge to that fold, like this, and you can fold all the way, like that. Now, you're going to make, yes, you already had this line right here, okay? You're going to make, fold on that line and make another mark here, okay, this. Okay, just like this. Now, okay, so you're going to bring this edge to the middle line. You can fold it up to this diagonal line here, okay? So from this diagonal all the way down, like this. Then you're going to bring the same edge to the crease you just did, and now you're going to fold so from the bottom to this, from the bottom to this point, yeah. Okay, so to this point right here. exquisite. Now, you're going to make... Let me just see what I miss. I have to do... Okay, so just to bring this edge to the middle and just make... Oh, it's already done, sorry. I couldn't see it. Okay, so bring this edge to this line, like this, don't fall all the way, just to the diagonal, just halfway, like this, and now you have this point right here. This point, you're going to make a line like this, okay? So just fold this point down and just hold here. Just pinch, fold it, okay? Like this. Now you're going to make a line, so you're going to bring this edge to this line, like this. You can fold all the way, okay? Now, sorry, I forgot something. So fold this edge to this line, and you need to fold it as well from this point all the way up. Okay, so just basically skipping this part, okay? So just fold it. Now you're going to fold this corner to that edge. This, and I think we're done. Yeah, I think so. Well, if we miss one, doesn't really matter. Okay, so let's start folding then. So you're going to fold this corner up like this, and the other one as well here, and now you're going to make reverse fold. So sorry, first you're going to bring this tip to this point, to the middle point, okay? You just squeeze through all the layers, sorry. And just bring the same point to the crease you just did. The reason for this is just because there are some lines that aren't creased, others are, but that should make it easier. And now you're just going to reverse inside reverse fold, so just open the paper and make this, okay? Just make this reverse fold, it should be quite simple, like this. Don't crease it tight yet, because you need to reverse fold this corner again. Like this, okay? Now you can crease it. Okay, now we're going to make a valley fold on this line, like this. Okay, so just open here. This is already a crease, but this one isn't. Okay, just open like this, you can align this edge with this one, like this, okay? And just make a valley fold here, just closing the paper. Like this. Sorry. I forgot to do if I keep doing this way it will end up like this. The white side are the dots. Well, I can turn back now, I just... God, sorry about that. If you want to start over, you can, but you'll have to make the creases all over again. Sorry, guys. Sorry about that. But, well, it doesn't mean it doesn't look cool. I actually think it looks cool this way, but people aren't used to it. That's the reason why, but sorry, guys. Okay, so again, sorry, just fold this tip down, okay, like this. Now do the same thing on the other side. Okay, now you're going to fold this corner down like this, and on this side you're going to make a mountain fold here. Basically you're just going to make a valley fold here and just squash this, okay? So, like this, okay? Just crease here. Okay, like this. Now, you're going to fold, you have this line here, right? We're going to fold it to the right, okay? Just crease it, unfold, and just reverse fold it, okay? So open here, just push the paper inside. Like this. Now, you have this line here, okay? You're going to fold this down on that line, make sure you keep the layers together, like this, and you're going to make a mountain fold on this line here, and a valley fold on this one, and a valley fold here, okay? So basically, just something like this, okay? Pretty straightforward, I think. Okay. Now, you're going to fold this corner all the way down. Okay. And sorry, camera ran out of battery. So as I was saying, you have this line right here, okay? You're just going to fold it, just the left side, okay, on that line, so we can make the same crease on the back. Just like this. And you're going to do the same thing on the other side. So basically, you can just fold like this and bring this point to this point here, okay? Something like this. Just fold here, okay? To here. Okay, just like this. Now, we're going to turn around and you're going to rotate and bring this point up till you can't no more, okay? So there will be a part where this, so basically just bring this point here, okay? Like this. It should align with this part here, okay? And just fold it. Okay, like this, and fold. Do the same thing on the other side. So basically, just you just need to bring this edge to the crease you just made. Just like this. Okay. Now, turn over again, and you're going to do some collapsing. So, you're going to make mountain folds on the lines, the crease you just did, and the valley fold on the middle, okay? So, just bring these two points together, okay? Just hold here. Here, on the top, as you can see, you have this square you just did, okay? So we're just going to fold, you're just going to open this part here, okay, open, and make, and push this square like this, okay, and just close the paper like this, okay? Now just do a belly fold on the middle, and just flatten it. Okay, like this. Make sure you crease it very well. Okay, now turn over. Oh, sorry. And just rotate it like this. Okay. Now you're going to fold all the way down, making a valley fold here, okay? Like this. Now, you're going to make a valley fold along this line, okay? So just fold this up. This. Okay, now you're going to reverse fold this triangle here. Okay, so just open here, make valley fold here on this line, all the way to this point, just make a mountain fold on this part, okay? Okay, like this. Let me just zoom in a little bit. Okay. Okay, now, sorry. Now we're going to do something. So you have, if you open here, you have this layer inside, okay? Basically, you're just going to unsync it. So basically, you're just going to pull it out and push this corner inside, okay? And make this a valley fold, okay? So just push this, like this. And just make a valley fold here, okay? And just fold it like this. Okay. Like this. Now. Okay. So now you're just going to open this a little bit and fold this flap to the left. This. Okay. Now, you're going to lift this corner up. This. You're just going to fold, you have this little flap, just going to fold it down and unfold it like this. Now you're going to open sync it, so just open here and just make a mountain fold here and here, and just make valley folds here, okay? Just again fold this flap to the left. Okay, like this. Now you're just going to reverse fold this corner. Okay. And now, again, reverse fold this corner. You're going to reverse fold it like this, okay? So, and just check something. I don't think, because I think I got it wrong this time. My question is if it's like this or like this. Let me just try to understand, just a second. Okay, it's like this, I think. I think it is. Okay, so just keep this flap behind and just hold it like this, okay? Okay, now you're going to close this. Okay, now you should have something like this. You're going to fold this flap to this edge this, just open it, opening this part, and you're going to open sync it. Okay, so just open here. Just make a mountain fold here. It's the same thing we did before. Okay. Just like this. Now you're going to turn around and do the same thing. So just fold this back to the right. Okay, and open sync. Okay, and turn them over again. Okay, you have something like this now. So you're going to fold this flap up, squashing this triangle. Like this. And fold it back down. Basically just reverse fold this. Okay, now turn around and you're going to fold this up, squashing this triangle like this. Okay, wait, oh sorry, it's not like that, sorry, you're going, it's the same thing, but this part is a mountain fold, okay, so just make a mountain fold here, and valley fold on this, okay, it's like this, sorry. Now, you're going to fold this flap to the right and squash this triangle. Like this. Now you're going to do a weird reverse fold. Basically, you're just going to reverse fold this part. Okay, so just go like this, okay, make a valley fold here, sorry, okay, like this, and just fold it down, like this, okay, I know it's weird. I'll show you again. So you had something like this, right? You're just going to make, if you open here, you're just going to make this valley fold and this one, okay? Just like this. Just fold this down. Okay. Now fold this up again. This and you're going to fold all this flap down on this line like this, okay? Okay, something like this, right? Now just turn over. Should have something like this. This flap is like this. Sorry. This is like this. Okay. Now is what you're going to do. You're going to make a valley fold on this line. Mountain fold here, here, and here. Okay, so basically just hold here, make a mountain fold on this and this one, and just fold till this point reaches this one. Okay, just pull this up like this, and you're just going to squash these triangles like this. Okay, this one as well. And just fold this triangle up. Like this, okay? Now, just reverse fold these triangles. Like this, and the other one as well. Okay, like this, and just fold this to the right, to the left, sorry, and just open and squash it, okay, like this. Just for you to get an idea, this square right here, it's the size of your cube, okay? It's one, I don't know how to say it in English. Well, it's one side of the cube, okay? It's like this. Okay, now you're going to fold this part like this. And this is another weird part. Let me just see. So, sorry guys, I had to figure out what to do. So, basically, you're just going to fold, you're just going to open here and fold this up, okay? But at the same time, you're going to open this part here, okay? And you're just going to make a mountain fold on this side, on this line, sorry. And then just close the paper, okay? Something like this. Okay. Now, okay, sorry. After all, this part was like this. This corner was like this. Okay. Now, okay, so just rotate 180 degrees. Now you have something like this, right? Now we're going to do the number 5 on this corner. Let me just zoom in a little bit. Okay, so you're going to fold this flap up. Like this. And you're going to divide this part into 3. Okay? So, just try it out. You can measure it with a ruler if you want to be more precise, but I don't think it's necessary. Okay. Okay, like this. See, like this. And now you have this part here, right? You're going to make a valley fold here, like this, and at the same time, so basically you're just going to swivel this part, okay? So just hold here and just keep swivel, just keep it going until you can't go no more, okay? Until you reach something like this, okay? You had something like this, right? Just keep pushing this like this, okay? And just squash the paper. Okay. Now you're going to bring this flap up like this. And you're going to bring this corner down like this, okay? Okay, do the same thing with this side. So to divide in 3, now it's easier. Just bring this point to this point like this. Now just fold it this deep back. Now again, here, you're going to make a valley fold here and just keep this part going like this. Now just fold this flap up. Can align it with this edge,
this one,
with this edge,
this,
and just fold this like so. Okay, so number 5 is done. Okay. Now, you're going to fold this down and you're going to divide into 3 parts again. So just do the same thing you did before. Okay, so it's divided. Ok, Okay, now you're going to do a mountain fold on this line. Okay, so just going to open here, do a mountain fold here, and then just do valley folds on this line and this one, okay? Like this. Okay? And just fold this corner up. This is going to be part of the number one. Okay, like this. Now, you're going to fold this part down and unfold. And basically, you're just going to do the same thing. Okay, just divide it into three parts. Basically, you want the same amount of white paper here. Then you want here, okay? So imagine you have a line like this. Basically, just divide it into three parts, like this. And just fold this mountain fold. Okay, so if you just, I'll show you how it's going to be the one. So you just need to bring these two parts together. You can look if they have the same size. Okay.
Mine is okay.
So I'll just leave it like this. Okay, next. Okay, so now it's number six, which I don't like because I don't get it, but I'll try to do it. Okay, so basically you're going to divide in three again. Yeah, you guessed it. So you're going to make mountain fold here,
just something like, just fold up then
here and just fold down. Don't crease all the way until you're sure. Okay. Okay, like this. Okay, now. Okay, guys, sorry. I had to pause the video again. I really can't understand. Well, this part is done. I don't know if it's the instructions that are wrong or it's just me that I suck. But anyways, I'll do the same thing I did. So basically, you're just going to open this part here and fold this flap down like this. Now, I can make like the divisions on this side, but on this one, it's not as easy. A solution for that, just crease it like this, okay? Then, and here as well. That way it looks more like it's six. Okay, that's the best I can do. But here, let me show you. So basically, you're going to fold this. You're going to squash fold, inside reverse fold this corner. Okay. And then, you're just going to open like this, okay? And you're going to close it. And do the same thing here, so just reverse fold this. Basically just reverse fold this part again, like this. Sorry about that, guys. It's really the best I can do. Okay. Well, moving on. Okay, so now I have something like this, right? Now you have. Now we're going to do this corner. So just fold this part down, and you're going to divide this part into three again. Basically the same thing. You're going to be pros dividing into third after, into third three parts after this. It's actually one of the things I hate about origami, dividing into three parts. I mean, I don't hate about origami, it's just one of the moves I don't like. Because it's, well, most of the times it's not perfect. But like on important models, I often use a ruler. You should try it. I'm not using here because I think it doesn't really matter. So okay, now you divide this side, now do the same thing here. Again, just bring this point to that one. And bring this point back. Okay, this is a three, okay? One, two, three. Now, so you're going to fold this to the left, and you're going to close it back, but you're going to bring this edge to this one, okay, making a line like this, and then you're going to make another one like this. Okay, so basically, just fold this part like this, okay, and just make a mountain fold here, okay, and just close it. Like this, okay? Now open it, now fold this again to the left, and you're going to open here this flap, and you're going to make a mountain fold on this line, this one and this one, okay? So just open here. I'm using a pencil to push out the creases, okay? So something like this. And just fold it like this, okay? Okay, like this. Okay, so now. Sorry, this part is on top. Wait. Yeah, put this part on top. So now, here's what you're going to do. You have this middle layer here, you're just going to fold it to this midline. Okay. Like this, and fold. Now, you're going to okay. Wait, when you fold this, fold the back one as well, okay? Fold like this. Ok, Okay, now you're going to basically you're going to make a valley fold on this line, okay, and the mountain fold on this line. So you're going to just push this part like this. Push this part inside here, and just squash the paper like this. Okay, let me do it again. And like this, just make a crimp inside. Like this, okay? Okay. Now, you're going to reverse, make a petal fold here. Like this, okay? And just close it. Like this. Now, you're going to bring this edge to the middle. And you're going to make, you see this line, like this, okay, this diagonal line, right? And you're just going to fold like this, okay? Just crease through all the layers. Like this. Okay, now you're going to open here in the middle, and you're going to fold this part to the right like this, and just just make like this, okay? Just bring this point up on this line, just align this edge with this one right here, and just crease this part. Okay. Like this. And now you're going to fold it down, fold this flap down on this line you have here. Like this. And at the same time, you're going to pull the paper inside here. Okay, and just squash it so it lies flat. Like this, okay? And just fold this corner up. So now you have number two right here. Let me show you. So, this is number two, sorry. Okay? Okay, now, there's only number four, which is going to be here. Let's do it. So, you're going to fold this flap to the left, like this. And now you're going to make a fold like this. So, you're going to divide this part into three parts, this edge into three, but just not supposed to crease it, just divide it, like, you know, mark it with a pencil like I'm doing, or just divide it mentally, I don't know what you want. And you're going to divide, I'll just divide it like this, okay? And you're going to make a line from this point to that division, okay? Like so. And you're just going to crease it. Okay. You have this flap right here, okay? Just crease it as well on that line. Okay, like this. Okay, now you're going to do some weird things. So basically, you're going to open here, and you're going to fold. Okay, just checking how it was. Okay, sorry. So basically, you had something like this, right? You're going to open here, and on this flap, you're going to make this line, okay? Belly fold here, like this, and another belly fold like this, okay? Here. Now, you're just going to squash the paper like so, and this part just squash it as best you can like this. Okay. Okay, I'll redo it. Okay, so you had something like this, right? Open here. Fold this flap like this. Fold here. Just, oh, this flap here, okay, this on the back. Just fold it to the left, to the right, sorry. And just squeeze it, okay? This just press down and here. Okay, now you're going to bring this point, so imagine there was a vertical line here. Okay, just bring that this edge to that point. To that line, sorry. And just fold this corner down like this. Yeah, I never get right with the four. No, but I think it's still better than the four I did here. Okay, and you're going to do the same thing with this flap. So again, just imagine there was a line here. Just fold this part down. This four is really bad.
Oh my god, sorry guys. As you can see,
this is supposed to be a square. This is supposed to be a square. Oh my. Okay. Anyways, I hope yours got better. You're just going to make another square.
Square.
Here. Okay, just fold this part to the left. And just squash it like this. Okay, like this. So you had like this, right?
Just do something like this.
And just fold these points like this. Okay. And that's done. Again, sorry for all the misunderstandings. I couldn't figure it out. But yeah, that's it. Wait, that's not it. I'm kidding. You still have to collapse it. Actually, this is not easy. I spent a lot of time trying to find the correct way to collapse it. But I'm going to show you. By the way, I used a lot of glue to make this things stick together, especially in all the points here. As you can see, mine didn't just pop out. And if you want to start collapsing, I suggest you use glue on these points first, okay, just to make this the paper plain, okay, just on the surface. Don't use it inside, okay. Just okay, don't use it inside, okay, because you don't know what you're going to need to open. Okay, so to the collapsing part now is what you're going to do. So you're going to make a mountain fold here along all of this line, okay, and you're going to make another mountain fold here, not all the way, just to here, okay. Now you're going to make a valley fold on this line, okay, so just bring these two edges together like this, just crease it, okay, so it will be easier to collapse, okay, like this. And now, okay, I think we can collapse it, so I'll show you what you're going to do. Oh, you're going to make a mountain fold like this, okay, and now you're going to fold this flap to the left like this, okay. Now you have number one here, number three, okay, so you have something like this, right? We can do it again, fold this like this and just fold it left. Okay, so now basically what you're going to do is, let me see, you're going to open this flap, okay, you're going to open it and make that valley fold we're talking about, okay, like this. Okay, now it seems weird, but for me it worked. The paper just started to... Oh, don't worry, I'll redo it. As you can see, sorry, it just starts to fold on its own, at least for me. Wait, let me just figure out how it is again. I'll just demonstrate again. Wait a second. Okay, I think I got it. Okay, so yeah, this is how it looks like without the glue. Okay, so let me explain it again. Okay, so you had something like this, right? Just fold like this and fold like this, right? Okay, so now here, this side, you're going to make a valley fold here, okay, and at the same time open this part, okay. So now all you have to do is, so you open here, okay, just fold it like this, and you have this part sticking out, right? You're just going to place it inside here, okay, just put it here, and that should do it. By the way, this this on the number one, if you reach this part, you don't have the squeeze, so you have to make it. Okay, but once again, I know this part is hard. Okay, so mountain fold here, here as well. Now here, just open here, belly fold, and you can press, you can hold here, and you have this little pocket here, right? You're just going to make a belly fold on this line. Like this. Sorry. So, just make that belly fold here. Wait. God, this is difficult. I'm not sure how to explain. Okay, so I have an idea. I'm going to start from the final form and just unfold it. Okay, so this is how it looks. Okay, so just going to open it, and this is where the hard part begins, right? When you have something like this. Okay. Okay, I'll give you a trick. Okay, so you're going to do. If you have here on the number one, you need to do this belly fold, okay? So you can just do it, just do like this, and just keep this square like this, okay? So you have number one here, okay? So now I'm just going to make again that same mountain fold. Belly fold here on the middle, okay, and just fold this part inside. Okay, I think this is the best I can explain you. I'll try it once again. So from the start, okay. So you had something like this, mountain fold here, again with the number one. What? Okay. Oh, you already have. Okay, so if you fold like this, you should get the number one, like this, right?
All you need to do is make a belly fold here. Okay, just push this corner,
okay, like this, and hold here,
hold like this.
Now belly fold here, and just push the paper inside. Like this. Okay, guys, that's it for the tutorial. Now you have a lot of gluing waiting for you, but it's worth it. Looks cool, right? And you can even play with it. Well, hope you could do this part, because it would be really frustrating if you came all this way and couldn't collapse it, but that would be my fault. But well, I did my best and explained you. So that's it, guys. Thank you very much for watching, and see you next time.
Bye.